Welcome back to another video with IDN TV. Now, if you guys are new to the channel, make sure you subscribe with the bell notifications on, especially if you're really interested in this Young Dolph news. You want to be updated with the official news, officially what's going on with Young Dolph. Make sure you subscribe with the bell notifications on and also hit the like button on this video. That way, when I post it, it comes straight to your phone. Now, we are on part 9. Now, if you guys haven't been caught up with the Young Dolph, I will leave a playlist at the end of this video. It'll actually go from 1 to 9 of all of the Young Dolph videos. News, his memorial service, when it first happened, what his friends, what his family has to say. It's all in that playlist, so make sure you guys take advantage of that and look at it. Now let's get right into the news. Now first and foremost, I like to start my videos off, I like to address the rumors. Now this was a terrible rumor. I even went on my community post to actually let you guys know, post in the actual picture that was floating around on social media that was allegedly saying it was Young Dolph inside of his casket is completely false. Again, I repeat, that is not Young Dolph in that casket. Now, here is the actual coffin that Young Dolph was in. It's 24 karat gold. And I know a lot of people are gonna be like, well, why would you put this up on social media? Why would you put this up on YouTube? His family posted it. Everybody's okay with them posting the actual casket. It was 24 gold. And like I said, Dolph went out on a nice way. Look at my last video. It shows the inside of the memorial service. It shows that people were there. Key Glock was there. His son Trey Trey was there. People, his artist, Gucci Man, 2 Chainz, everybody was there to show love to Young Dolph. Now, one thing that I did see, that it wasn't a lot of industry people at Young Dolph's actual memorial service, which shows that he kept it true to himself. He kept a circle that was really small, especially in the music community. Just watching videos and interviews of Young Dolph leading up till today, it shows that Young Dolph was not fake. He didn't kick it with people that he really didn't rock with. He had a few friends in the industry, and like I said, it was like Gucci Man, 2 Chainz, Rick Ross, and people like that. So now let's jump into the news. Now we are getting the official street named after Young Dolph. Now according to the reports in Fox 13 Memphis, it will be Dunn Avenue and Airways Boulevard. Now this actual street name will be Young Dolph's name. I don't know if they're gonna make it his official real name or it will be Young Dolph Boulevard, but now this location will be near the Memphis Deport Industrial Park. Now I want to say this, I feel like this is great. Unfortunately, Young Dolph lost his life, but this will be a monumental street. A lot of people will come into Memphis, and instead of going wherever they go when they get to Memphis, they're going straight to that boulevard. If I ever went out to Memphis or the Tennessee area, I'm definitely going to go and pay my respects to Young Dolph. But once I have the official unveiling and things like, I will post a video for you guys to, you know, check it out and things like that. Now moving along, now I have some more official exclusive information. Now a person posted this on their Instagram. Now they live in this condo. Now this condo was the actual location when Young Dolph filmed his last music video. Not the last music video meaning a week before he passed, the same exact day. So they're saying that Young Dolph from 9 a.m. to 12 p.m. was filming that music video Wednesday, November 17th, 2021. Don't believe me? Here it goes. It shows the Landing residence, and it's on 1 Dr. Martin Luther King Avenue in Memphis, Tennessee. And it seems like, it looks like they reserved the club lounge, which was reserved, like I said, from 9 a.m. to 12:30. Now somebody, I'm not gonna reveal their actual name, they revealed this. He says, "You was just at my condo shooting a video on the rooftop, and then I hear you got killed. This is sad. And if this doesn't show me that I need to move different, it is what it is." Now, RIP Young Dolph, it shows a Dolph emoji with the praying hand emojis. Like I told you guys, a lot of information is just being swept under the rug, but I'm sure that the authorities and the police and people that are investigators are backtracking. But I just wanted to give you guys a little bit of exclusive information that Dolph was filming a music video. I don't know what for particular video or what particular music, what particular track, but he did film a music video. Like I said, he was wearing the yellow with the blue hat. So if a video comes out and he's wearing that yellow and blue hat, you guys heard it here first, and you know that he was filming this music video at the Landing residence. Now, just going on just social media, man, like I said, I've been looking around trying to find news and information. Now, one of these bloggers are saying that they're really connected to some authorities in the Memphis area, and they're saying that they have low down information on Young Dolph. Now, allegedly they're saying that Dolph was hit 23 times, which I do not find that, I don't find that a surprise. One guy came up with a Draco and another one came up and they were on Young Dolph. So 23, allegedly, this is what they're saying, 23 times. Now, a lot of people were figuring, okay, we're going to get the footage from inside the cookie store. We're going to get footage from a surveillance somewhere around the area. Usually when somebody passes away, they have all of the surveillance footage, even when it actually happened. You got to remember, it goes all the way back to Bankroll Fresh. They showed that incident. So everything was on surveillance, but now we're waiting to see that surveillance. Now, I feel like a lot of the fans and a lot of supporters of Young Dolph, we're not waiting for this surveillance footage to be weird. There's a lot of questions that haven't been answered, and we genuinely want to know what happened to Young Dolph. So that kind of makes me scratch my head. I don't know if this case is going to be solved anytime soon. Remember, you guys, I was saying the first week or two, I was saying this case was going to be solved by the end of the week, but it seems like they ran into a dead end after that car was found. It was a lot of speculation saying that the person that passed away at that same area was the person involved and actually did it. No real information has came out, so that's a rumor as well. Now, moving along, I want to salute Young Dolph's girlfriend, baby mama, wife, whatever you want to call it, respectfully. Right next to the cookie store where Young Dolph passed away, his wife, or the company that his wife is associated with, they posted a billboard. Now, check this out. It says, "Black men deserve to grow old." It shows Dolph. It shows a lot of people, Pop Smoke. It shows a lot of people that passed away. And mind you, this is right above the cookie store. So it shows the strength in Young Dolph's wife. It shows that she's really trying to push this narrative. And keep in mind, like I said, this company has been around for a while. This is not just a company that popped up after Dolph passed. So it shows that his wife and the people around him are really trying to carry this message. And I definitely salute you guys. If you guys haven't got a chance to check out her website or Instagram, I will leave it in the description below. Make sure you guys cop up, you know, get some clothes, get a hoodie, and show the respect. Now, they're planning a official memorial service. Like I said, they had the private memorial service for Dolph, where, you know, he was actually in the casket and his family and friends and close people, but now they're having one to the public. Now, a public memorial for Young Dolph is planned to be held at the FedEx Forum on Thursday, December 16th from 10 a.m. to 2 p.m. Now, this is according to Young Dolph's publicist. Now, they are processing the finalizing this contract at this forum. I think this actual location is where, like, the Grizzlies, Memphis University plays on that big game. So it will be, you know, it kind of reminds me of what happened to Hustle back in California at the Staples Center. I think it'll be the same type of thing, but it'll be more for the public. I'm sure a lot of celebrities will show up. So it's been 3 weeks. They're still asking for people if they have any information about what happened to call the Crime Stoppers, you know, because they're saying that this case is in a standstill, but the community is concerned. So that's all the information I have. I don't have any official information because it's not out. A lot of people are running with the rumors, and I'm entertained by it. I feel like a lot of information is valid. I feel like a lot of information is cap. So you guys decide, how do you feel about it? Here is the playlist 1 through 9 now. So make sure you catch up on the Young Dolph, because once new information comes out, you'll be the first to hear from IDN TV. Subscribe, hit the like button. I will catch you on the next video.